Alright guys, what is up? Captain Fraser here. Welcome aboard the Flying Fish here. I'm solo today and I'm just doing a quick trip to run this boat probably for one of the last times. It's for sale. After 12 years or so, I'm selling this boat. And I've completed a brand new deck all the way throughout. Gel coat, non-skid throughout. Had it all polished up, shined up. And this back section actually of the deck here, aft, a little bit soggy. I didn't feel comfortable selling it that way. The deck was a little weak, so I went ahead, ripped it all out, and sold that. Oh man, look at this alligator here. It'd be nice to have an alligator here. So anyway, replaced the deck. Didn't feel comfortable selling it that way. So I went ahead and finished and fixed it all up. Walking up front here, got the Minnkota 80-pound thrust spot lock trolling motor. Anchor cabinet, I'm giving it away with two anchors, so if you're sandbarring, you can get one forward and aft, bow and stern. We've got a 200-watt amp, Jensen marine amp underneath the console cover here. The electronics and the dual battery 8 amp dual troll motor charger. This is a little bit difficult. Man, there's a lot of bait here. A little difficult doing this by myself, so bear with me. Alright, so let's see. Up front on the console here, we've got the Lowrance side scan, down scan, GPS plotter, all integrated. This is the network, so you can, underneath, we do have the network hub underneath the cabinet, so you can go ahead and link your radio and instruments and everything to that. Here we have the Mercury command with digital reading here for all of the gate motor functions. Here we have a Boss Stereo VHF, and of course the Mercury Pro XS 115 command thrust, 2018 with 1 year of warranty left on it. Super clean. We got the swim ladder that I don't usually put on, as well as the bimini top, or the little folding top for families and so on to enjoy the boat. Plenty of storage up front underneath the front seat, and also we got this, I installed this huge tackle storage which will hold about 8 Plano boxes. Really good feature there, bigger than most bay boats. Comes with all the safety gear, USCG life jackets and everything. Little cell phone holder here. Got the new windshield put on, the trailer's all stainless steel aluminum. We got extra rod holders up front. We got, of course, two speakers forward, two on each side of the console. The sub in the back with two more speakers back here. Just refreshed all the bilge, hose, and so on. Also, I have the custom 20-gallon on-deck live well with the tuna tubes that you can put, if you're offshore, even inshore, you can put mullet, goggle eyes, little bonita, and plenty of room in here. 20-gallon tank plumbed through the hull. A real nice feature. It is removable if you want. Custom made in the same color gel coat to match. So that's a real nice addition there. I think I bought that for about $400. So a good value here on the boat with everything that's included on it. So, leaning post, taco leaning post. Alright guys, I'm gonna probably show you some stills, and from there, I've been trying to rush this video. My dad's back in the dock, the sun's going down, gotta get back. But alright, we're gonna do a little shoot here of top speed, cruising speed as well. there, pinned and 37. There she is. 38. And then here's your cruise. Cruising at about 4.5, just under 4.5, 4,400 there. And the neat thing about this gauge is it actually does your gallons per hour. So right now at 28 miles per hour, 4,500 RPM, you're actually burning 5.7 gallons per hour. 40 gallon tank, pretty good. And from there, been trying to rush this video. My dad's back at the dock, the sun's going down, gotta get back. But yeah, any questions, comments, feel free to leave them. Had this boat super long time, really good condition, all waxed up, pictures here to come, and I'll see you guys in the next one. See ya.